alternating form of trophozoite versus cyst. the vertical between the two different forms. And lastly, I describe two forms of that reproduction, that is asexual, also known as fission, and the sexual form, known as conjugation. And that concludes the lecture on protozoa.
Welcome. This is Professor Joe Borden, and today I'm going to talk to you about two different types of metabolic pathways, or subsets of metabolic pathways, what are called catabolic and anabolic pathways. Like all metabolic pathways, these pathways are defined by the enzymes that make them. So the basic subunits of any pathway are the enzymes that come together. So I have a hypothetical pathway here, and it's consisting of three enzymes, 1, 2, and 3. This pathway begins by acting on substrate A and making a final product, D. Along the way, A needs to interact with an enzyme, very specific enzyme, through the active site. A is converted by enzyme B into its product, B. A interacts with enzyme 1 to make a product, B. Now, this B, being a product of enzyme 1, is also a substrate, a very specific substrate, for enzyme 2. Now, when it interacts with enzyme 2, it's converted to a product, C, but this product, C, likewise, is a substrate for enzyme 3. Again, after going through the chemical reaction, it's converted to C, we have our final product, and this pathway now has converted all the three substrates that are present in the environment to product, D. Okay, that's pretty much true for all metabolic pathways. So metabolic pathways are represented here in blue, that's what we're talking about. But some of these pathways are called catabolic pathways. Catabolic pathways. So what catabolic pathways do is they take large molecules and break them up into smaller ones. So I'm showing you some food, nutrients that a cell will use. If they go through a catabolic pathway, it's a pathway that's slower, but they're going to take these large molecules and break them up into smaller molecules. Now, what catabolic pathways have in common is by breaking chemical bonds to make small molecules, they're going to release energy, chemical energy, and that's going to be in the form, a usable form for the cell, and that's called ATP. Some energy is going to be released, but it's not usable if it's given off that heat. So that's catabolism. Let's erase these marks. We'll talk about anabolism. Anabolism is that occurs through anabolic pathways. Should be two words, the pathways are sort of that close. We're going to start with anabolic pathways, we're going to start with small molecules. These small molecules, with the aid or assistance of ATP, of energy, ATP, then we convert those small molecules into larger macromolecules. So this data is going to require energy that was provided by the catabolic pathway. So what I want you to remember is that catabolism breaks out large molecules and makes small molecules in the process of making ATP. Anabolic pathway takes that energy, that ATP, along with the small molecules and converts them into large molecules. So I want you to realize that the catabolism and anabolism, or catabolic pathway and anabolic pathway, are somewhat intertwined. Here's another picture that sort of shows the same thing. Basically, it's showing you that catabolism is entering the cell, it's releasing energy ATP, it's going to